Hello friends, I am Panindra Gupta and if you like this video, please subscribe my channel and also press the bell icon for the latest updates. Thank you. Guys, you can also join us in Facebook and also in WhatsApp. So if you have any doubts regarding any topic, you can ask me over there. So the link will be given in the description box. And for clear notes on my topics, please you can check my link www.biomedhistory.com and the link will be given in the description box.
Hi friends, my name is Panindra Gupta. So in this video, let us discuss about Enterobius vermicularis. It is a scientific name of pinworm, and pinworm is a common name. So pinworm is a parasite and scientific name it is called as Enterobius vermicularis, and the disease which is mainly caused by this parasite pinworm is known as enterobiasis. So enterobiasis is a disease which is mainly caused by a pinworm. Okay, so let us normally this pinworm can be seen only in the parts of colon and rectum. Normally it is passed from the intestine, but it gets settled towards colon and rectum. Colon and rectum is a part at the end, it is the end part of the large intestine which is present towards the anus. So coming to the structure of pinworm, and the structure of the pinworm is bisexual, that is nothing but it can be differentiated into male pinworm and as well as female pinworm. So if you see this, this is the structure of the male worm and this is the structure of the female worm. So coming to the male worm, so normally we know the differences between male pinworm and female pinworm, that is nothing but male pinworm consists of testes whereas female pinworm consists of ovaries, and the sperms are mainly generated in the testes, and in the ovaries formation of eggs takes place. That is nothing but when both male worm and female worm undergoes copulation, then there will be releasing of formation of eggs. So the sperms which are mainly present in the testes will enter into the ovaries due to the process of copulation and mainly releases the eggs. So coming to the male pinworm, it is curved posterior end. So if you see here in the structure of the male worm, it is curved posterior end, and coming to the size, it is 2 to 5 millimeters long and 0.2 millimeters in thick. So coming to the female pinworm, it has sharp posterior end. This is the anterior end and this is the posterior end, as well as here also same anterior end. There is nothing but it consists of mouth over here and it consists of anus at the posterior end. So here the posterior end is curved in the male worm, whereas in the female worm the posterior end is sharp. So coming to the size of the female worm, it is long, it is 8 to 13 millimeters long and 0.5 millimeters thick. So coming to the next point and the final growth size of larva, there is nothing but after the hatching of egg there will be releasing of larva, right? And the final size of that larva is 140 to 150 micrometers in length, and after copulation there is a release of eggs, I have said you, right? And the size of that egg is 50 to 60 micrometers. So now let us discuss about the life cycle of pinworm. So before starting into the life cycle, I have to say you one point, that normally the male worms, the lifespan of male worm is 7 weeks and the lifespan of female worm is 12 to 13 weeks. So coming to the life cycle, and normally the fecus which is mainly released by the man consists of eggs which is mainly released by the pinworm, female pinworm. Okay, I will say you it in life cycle. So the eggs will finally reach us into the contaminated food and water, and this contaminated food and water will be intake by the humans, will be ingested into the humans. So the eggs which are mainly present in the contaminated food and water will enter into the stomach, and from the stomach it enters into the duodenum. So within the duodenum, hatching of eggs takes place. So if you see here properly, I have drawn here, the blue color one which I have drawn here is the egg, and the egg undergoes hatching and mainly releases worms. Okay, adult worms, there is nothing but adult worms. And coming to the next one, this duodenum undergoes hatching and mainly releases worms. Hatching of eggs in the duodenum and mainly releases the worms, and that worms will reach us up to the small intestine, and up to the small intestine, and within the small intestine the growth takes place, and after the growth it enters into the colon and it becomes adult in size, and becomes adult, that is nothing but it can undergo copulation, it is in the stage of the copulation. Okay, and finally it enters into the ileum. So within the ileum, what happens? The copulation of male worm and female worm takes place. So due to the copulation, copulation is nothing but mating, that is nothing but sperms which are mainly present in the testes will enter into the ovaries which are mainly present in the female worm, that is nothing but this process known as copulation. So due to the process of copulation, what happens? The final result will be the releasing of eggs, and that eggs which are mainly present in this, which is mainly released by this female worm, will enter into the last part of the large intestine. That is nothing but end part of the large intestine. And within the and after releasing of eggs, immediately the male worm will get died. The male worm will get died. I have said you in the beginning point that male worm can survive only 7 weeks, right? So within the 7 weeks, it undergoes copulation in such a way that the eggs will be released, and after releasing of eggs, the male worm will get died, and soon after the female worm will also get dead. After that is nothing but after 12 to 13 weeks. So when the both male and female worm will get died, then the eggs which are mainly present at the last part of the intestine will enter into the will enter into towards the anus, so which can be exposed. So finally, these eggs which are mainly present, so this is the large intestine, right? And from the large intestine, it enters up to the anus. All of these eggs will reach up to the anus, and from the anus, it will be exposed towards bum region, towards the bum region. So bum region is nothing but it is a visible part which is present at the anus. Okay, so this all of these eggs will reach up to the anus, and from the anus, these eggs will be released out at the bum region. I have said you, if you see here, this is the bum region, and within the bum region, all of these eggs will be exposed. All of these eggs will be exposed. So due to the exposure of these eggs, what happens is itching of anus, itching at the place of the anus takes place. There is nothing but it comes under the symptoms. I will say you the next one. So all of these eggs which are mainly present towards the anus, when the fecus is mainly released from the anus, then the eggs which is mainly present at the buttocks region will come along with the fecus. And again, the eggs which are mainly present in the fecus will enter into the contaminated food and water. From the contaminated food and water will intake by the humans, and it enters up to the stomach, and within the part of the duodenum, hatching of eggs takes place. Due to the hatching of eggs, there will be release of larva. So adult stage of larva, there's nothing but adult stage of larva, and finally it enters into the small intestine. Within the small intestine, it undergoes growth, and after small intestine, it enters into the large intestine. Within the large intestine, it enters up to the colon, and within the colon, it gets into adult stage. Adult stage is nothing but it can undergo the stage of copulation. Okay, from the colon, it enters into the ileum. So within the ileum, copulation of male worm and female worm takes place. There is nothing but sperms which are mainly present in the testes of male worm will enter into the ovaries of female worm, and within the ovaries, formation of eggs takes place. So after mating, there is nothing but after copulation, eggs will be released out. So immediately after releasing of eggs, first male worm will get died. So after death of the male worm, within the few days, female worm will also get died. So if you see here, the lifespan of male worm is 7, and the lifespan of female worm is 12 to 13 weeks. So after releasing of eggs, these eggs will reach us up to the last part of the large intestine. Within the large intestine, all of the eggs will get collected, and after the collecting of all the egg will be reaches to the last part. That is nothing but it reaches up to the anus, and when it reaches to the anus, all of these eggs will be exposed towards the bum region. So if you see here, this is the bum region, and the blue color one which I have drawn are the eggs, and all of these eggs are exposed towards the bum region. So finally, along with the fecus matter, which will be released by the anus, the eggs will along with the fecus will be released out, and total life cycle will again get repeated. So now let us discuss about the symptoms. So symptoms includes itching at perineum. There is nothing but perineum is at the part of the anus. You will get itching at the part of the anus. And second one is tickling, crawling sensation, skin inflammation, hair follicle inflammation, weight loss, high fever, emotional instability, irritation, unable to control urine. So coming to the diagnosis, attaching of scotch tape at the anus. So scotch tape is nothing but it is a tape which is in the transparent, it will get attached to the anus. So due to the attachment of the anus at the part of the anus, the eggs which are mainly present at the anus, eggs are nothing but which are mainly released by the pinworms, will get attached to the tape. So and the tape will be removed out. So the eggs which are mainly present at the part of the anus will be removed out. There is nothing but it gets attached to the tape. And another diagnostic test is colonoscopy. Colonoscopy is nothing but it is a test which is mainly used to identify the egg whether it belongs to pinworm or not. Okay, so coming to the treatment, what are the drugs which are mainly given for the person who is infected with this type of diseases are albendazole, mebendazole, helmintox, benzimidazole, piperacillin. So this is the structure of pinworm, life cycle, symptoms, diagnosis and treatment. So at the beginning I have said you that recently we have created a blog, that's nothing but it is a website. So notes for this topic will be given in that blog, and the link of that blog will be given in the description box. So people who are interested to watch that notes, please open the link. So thank you for watching this video, guys. If you like this video, please do like and subscribe. And if you have any doubts regarding this video, please comment in the comment box. Thank you.